I think the euro doesn't have too much downside from here. In the short term, the noise that we are getting out of Germany, just keep in mind that political issues on Germany doesn't really affect the underlying growth of Germany. So on that side, we don't think that the ECB would materially change its decision to step back on monetary stimulus withdrawal based on what is happening in Germany. So on the euro dollar, we are actually quite positive. If we do get to a level of 115 or slightly below, we would be quite keen to add exposure to the euro.
Okay, but so far you think there's more downside from here or no?
In the very near term, maybe if the US tax reforms get a bit more progress, because the Senate is actually voting on the final bill next week, there could be a knee-jerk reaction on the dollar on the upside. So we might actually get a better entry level on the euro dollar.
And speaking of Yellen, she's due to announce her Fed minutes later on today. I think today or tomorrow, I'm not sure. But Fed, this is the November Fed meetings. Anything there that could perhaps move the dollar?
It should be a non-event because the data out of the US in the last month has been quite strong. So the fact that the market has already priced in a December rate hike to a very large degree, the Fed would be actually very cautious to shift the market expectations at such a late point in time.
Do you like dollar yen? I mean, we had a guest on earlier who says he likes dollar yen because rates are going to move higher in the US and there are no rate movements in Japan. So he likes dollar yen. Do you like dollar yen?
We will share that view because on the Japan side, there is frankly very little political risk on the immediate horizon. Since Abe won the elections, the leader of the opposition party recently resigned. So on the near term, the Abenomics story will still be around. And on top of that, if they were to reappoint Governor Kuroda next April, it would just mean more policy continuity. So the Bank of Japan would most likely be one of the last central banks to withdraw monetary policy stimulus. And for that reason, we actually think that the yen would stay weak. And from current levels, 112, we are looking for an upside of towards 115.